It's nice to have you here. Welcome. In this video, we are going to fully evolve the RSVP block to display the RSVP form we created earlier. While we do this, we are also going to introduce functionality to apply access control to the block based on permissions. To complete the code, let's introduce ourselves to three Drupal functions we have not yet used: form builder getForm, access result allowed if has permission, and block access. GetForm returns a renderable form array. If it is passed the name of a form class which implements form interface, we will use this GetForm method to return the RSVP form to be displayed in the RSVP block. The allowed if has permission function is a bit more complex, but it introduces us to the concepts of applying access control. The allowed if has permission function returns an access result object, which we can leverage to determine whether or not a user gets shown a block based on whether or not they have permission. Allowed if has permission is used within the method called block access. The block access method is responsible for indicating whether the block should be shown. This method is to be used if a block is to perform access checking. Nice work. This completes the introduction to these three functions. Let's begin coding. Have your code editor ready to go with the RSVP list module loaded. All right, let's do this. Open the rsvpblock.php file for editing. Remember, it is located in the directory rsvplist src plugin block. In order to have this block display the RSVP form, visit the build method of this class. Instead of returning a markup render array, we need to return a form render array. So, follow along and remove or comment out the existing return statement. And in its place, type return Drupal form builder get form Drupal RSVP list form RSVP form. Notice that with the getForm function, we pass it the full namespace to the RSVPform class as a string. This Drupal RSVP list form RSVPform refers to this file in our module here at rsvplist src form rsvpform.php. Remember that we do not type src in the namespace, because src is a special directory associated with the autoloading magic of PSR4. Anyway, if we were to look at the RSVPform class itself, we can see that we do not even ever mention src in its namespace. I'll open the rsvpform.php file to briefly show you this. Here, in the rsvpform.php, the namespace we declare is Drupal RSVP list form. And the class name is rsvpform, so the full namespace to this class is Drupal RSVP list form rsvpform, which is exactly what we typed here in the build method of the RSVP block class in rsvpblock.php. Hope that clears up any confusion. Okay, let's continue on. Your build method of the RSVP block class should look like this, using form builder getForm to return the form render array. Next, let's implement the block access method. Below the build method, enter the block access method like so, including the doc block. Notice that the parameter of account is of type account interface. We'll use this parameter soon. The next step is to attempt to load the node that the block is currently displayed on. Remember that according to the implementation requirements of this module, that events are nodes on the site and only events can be RSVP'd to. Type be sure to type the closing curly bracket for the if statement. We have seen this code before in the build method of rsvpform. If the current route is to a node, then we want to perform an access check to make sure that the current user has the appropriate permission. Within the if statement, type allowed if has permission takes two parameters, the account to check and the machine name of the permission to check for. Based upon what is returned by allowed if has permission, this block access method will determine whether the block is shown to the user or not. But remember, as per the requirements, this block should only ever be displayed on nodes which have been indicated by site admins to be events. So, going outside of the if statement, by default, we will return an access result of forbidden with this line of code. Awesome! So this completes the code for now. In future videos, we will come back to modify this block access method to implement a custom RSVP enabler service we will build. For now though, double check your code, save the file, and head over to your site to check the functionality of what we just built. Great. So clear the cache, and then visit the front page of your site. I'm already there. Notice that by default, the RSVP block will not be shown on the front page because the default front page is not a node unless configured to be a node under the system configuration settings. However, if I view a node, such as this Welcome to Drupal Module Development article created earlier, I will see the RSVP block and form. Yeah! I see this block because I am an admin with permissions to see this block, and this is a node. Remember that we had given permission to the anonymous user to also view the RSVP form. Well, if I open up the site with a new session in a private window, I expect to see the same results as I did as an admin. Sure enough, on the front page, I see no block as expected. And if I visit the article, I do see the block. Fantastic. This is working as expected. However, if I go back to my site as an administrator and remove the view RSVP form permission from the anonymous users, save permissions, then if I revisit the site as an anonymous user, if I visit the same article again, there is no RSVP form. Incredible! Before we conclude this video, be sure to go back as an administrator and give the view RSVP form permission back to anonymous users. Well, this completes the tasks of this video. Congratulations on making it this far. What we have achieved here sets the stage for us to implement the learning and future RSVP functionality in upcoming videos. These include creating an RSVP administrator form, which uses configuration to determine which node types are applicable as event types, and then altering the node edit form of those indicated event types, and we will create a custom Drupal service. It's all tying together beautifully, and it's getting exciting. Again, super job from you in your learning efforts. Take a break if you need to, and view the resources if you wish. Happy learning.